show everyone has been looking forward to in 2020 is finally here. The hype has been real, and I have to say that the Mirzapur team has built the anticipation for the show so much that I just became more and more excited as the months went by about what will happen in the Badlands of Purvanchal. Rather than giving you a recap of what happened in season 1 before I start the review, which you can watch for yourself in the Mirzapur season 1 recap video on Amazon Prime Video's YouTube channel, let's just get to brass tacks, to where we left off and the multiple subplots that will follow beyond Guddu and Golu getting their revenge from Munna Bhaiya and the possibility of them overthrowing the current king of Mirzapur. Munna Bhaiya has Roose Bolton style caused absolute havoc by eliminating Sweetie and Bablu. The wedding massacre by Munna came to an abrupt halt, leading to Guddu, who is critically injured, to abscond with Dimpy and Golu. We follow Sharad from Jaunpur, who is mourning the loss of his father, setting his eye towards the throne of Mirzapur. Kaleen Bhaiya is strategizing his political influence by removing all middlemen directly concerned with the elections. Munna in recovery mode still has sociopathic tendencies of being unpredictable and his pursuit to prove to his father that he is worthy of the throne. Beena is constantly in a tussle in the Tripathi household, having to satisfy her tormentor even though she has something mischievous planned. The struggle of the simpleton parents, Lala, the supplier of opium, identifying the best moment to strike back. Guddu and Golu, fueled with the power of vengeance, having only Mirzapur as their ultimate goal. The influence and allegiance of the police and all the new characters that get introduced all form the crux of season 2. Here's me telling you the good and bad aspects of season 2 so that you guys can ultimately decide. One second. Who am I kidding? Let's just get straight to the point. You're gonna watch it anyway. The underwhelming aspects. Creative choices. The 10-episode series has many creative choices that I felt were either unnecessary or slowed down the pace of what originally excited and invested viewers. There is a need in the story to have an abundant amount of item songs. These songs are mostly presented as background to the actual action taking place and sometimes to present what happens in close quarters with a few characters. The general flow of the plot always seemed to come to a jarring halt when it transitioned to a belly dance number in close quarters or even a Bhojpuri tune on television in a barber shop. There is a dialogue in the series which points out that the population of Bihar has only two fates, either to be a criminal or a civil servant. A gross generalization, I felt, to an entire state. The two biggest issues I had with the series and its writing is pertaining to the new characters introduced in season 2. Madhuri, played by Isha Talwar, an extremely capable actor, plays the role of the chief minister's daughter, who is educated, sharp, and indoctrinated in the world of politics. What I absolutely hated was that her character almost became a pushover or a doormat with Munna. There is a point where there is an absolute breach of trust in their relationship, and Madhuri passes it off as not such a big deal. Something that came across as a shock to me, for it is not how her character is introduced. To represent her as a woman who is a catalyst to expose the vulnerable and human side of Munna did not require her to be hurt and assume that men will be men. The second character, Vijay Verma, has an interesting surprise, which I thought there would be a more profound impact on the storyline. The more I explored the series, the less I thought this surprise element regarding his character was required. Other than one circumstantial moment, there was literally no need of this surprise. His character and the predicament he finds himself in unintentionally became a subplot of an Abbas Mastan film, rather than having the realism of what Mirzapur was known for. This has nothing to do with Vijay Verma, who is phenomenal, but the creative choice regarding his character. Inconsistent story development. Audiences were the most excited about Guddu and Golu and their path of vengeance. When there is a clear goal in a series and what the audiences are going to expect, there is a higher chance of disappointment as there is an expectation. Season 1 just explored the world of Mirzapur, something that we were not privy to. But we know this world right now, so there is an expectation to see more of your favorite characters and get justice. The series in its development really steers towards the human connection of several characters. So the rage that is ripe, real, and fresh in Guddu and Golu's memories simmers down a bit as the episodes go by, which make you sometimes want the show to go back to what you signed up for originally. Whether it be Golu's internal struggle, confusion, and how it manifests into some odd form of violence, or Guddu and the development of a romantic interest, it really does momentarily extinguish the fire that keeps this show going. The good. Memorable dialogues. What I absolutely love about the show is that it still has the ability to have hilarious and memorable dialogues that will become memes as the years go by. This is both a case of the brilliant writing by the creators as well as the exceptional performances of the star cast. The brilliance of the second season is also not only restricted to the humorous dialogues, but more the cerebral and emotional moments. A key feature of why the second season is different from the first. While Lala remembers the atrocities at the wedding, he says, "Takleef unki nahi hoti jo chale jaate hain." Unki hoti hai jo peeche reh jaate hain. In wanting to garner political clout, Kaleen Bhaiya is advised by his father, "Kutte ke malik ko dost bana lo. Kutta bhonkna band kar dega." Kaleen Bhaiya has some of the most hilarious dialogues as well, describing JP Yadav as a pretend chuta and upon being rejected for sex, announcing himself as a non-performing asset. I couldn't stop rolling on the floor laughing. Rather than me ruining the experience of you listening to several other dialogues for the first time, I'll just reassure you that there are many that will stay with you, especially from Munna and Kaleen Bhaiya. Moments. What stood out to me in this series beyond the chemistry and acting performances among the talent is the brilliant editing and camera work. The editing by Manan Mehta stands out especially for me with respect to the structure of each episode. The timing in which the opening and closing credits come on cue is absolutely perfect, developing interest at the start with a bombshell of what will transpire and eventually to come to the conclusion with a cliffhanger in almost each episode, compelling viewers to click on the next one. Sanjay Kapoor's work with cinematography also stands out, especially in one sequence that will remind you of the multi-story building scene from season 1. A one-shot sequence of a planned attack that transitions from breaking into a hand-to-hand and gun battle as the lights are categorically switched off. As I previously said, the series is much more internalized with respect to the characters and what they are going through in season 2, as compared to the plethora of action-oriented violence in season 1. While Mirzapur does not go overboard with its cerebral and social overtones like Sacred Game season 2, there are many moments that will stay with you and maybe even tear you up in the new season of Mirzapur. Guddu breaking down in front of his parents, or Guddu and Golu finally being vulnerable with one another at a time where they are forced to put on a brave face. The editing also brilliantly creates contrast with other characters in different phases of their life. While Guddu prepares for revenge attempting to raise a gun, Beena feels cornered, wanting to end everything. Both scenes shown together side by side, you will be exposed to shades of characters that you never expected, which can be a coin toss for a viewer experience. Do you give the viewer what they wanted and what made season 1 popular, or something fresh that they never expected? Performances. Every single actor from season 2 puts forth a praiseworthy performance. While the writing regarding some characters can be termed as rather odd and left field, the performances cannot be criticized. From the main cast, I believe Ali Fazal as Guddu and Divyendu as Munna stand out this season. Guddu is no more the starry-eyed gullible boy that could be easily swayed. He is agile, vigilant and extremely sharp. Something that I was expecting in season 2. Fazal perfectly combines the character's determination for revenge as well as the self-reflection he is compelled to do due to the loss of his closest family members. Fazal especially stands out in the emotional moments, a side of the actor I believe has been best showcased in this season. Divyendu has completely imbibed the essence of Munna, and surprisingly in this season we also get to see the human and more vulnerable side of him. He still has sociopathic tendencies and is completely off the rails and unpredictable, which makes his sequences stand out as some of the most enjoyable ones. I believe Pankaj Tripathi is just a legend. He is Kaleen Bhaiya. If you look at all the memeable dialogues from Mirzapur, I don't think anyone can imagine any other actor play Kaleen Bhaiya other than Pankaj Tripathi. He has this restraint in his dialogue, he has this calmness, and in that calmness in itself, he has the ability to annihilate every character just through his words. He is one legend I can't speak enough for. Among the new characters that really left a lasting impact, I would like to say that Anjum Sharma as Sharad Shukla from Jaunpur is brilliant. His body language and baritone dialogue delivery showcases the sheer talent the man possesses. He is responsible for sowing the seed in several instances to cause mayhem. While Isha Talwar and Vijay Verma are great actors, the inconsistent writing of their characters does not make their introduction soar to become one for the ages to remember. Priyanshu is introduced as Robin, a wheeler dealer of sorts, who makes me come to the conclusion that I will in every situation say, "Ye bhi theek hai." Similarly, while Shweta Tripathi as Golu does as is required with respect to what the script demands, her transition into this rather absurd, self-hurting phase took me away from feeling invested in her personal journey. The surprise packages according to me are Rasika Dugal as Beena, that has progressed from being subservient and simple-minded to calculated and conniving, causing chaos in her own household. Also, can I say, Maqbool played by Shajit Chaudhary is one of my favorite characters, reminding me of Mark Strong from Rock and Roller, a no-nonsense loyal right-hand man. His character arc is the one that really stays with you. You have to realize that this show will not cater to what made it popular in season one. It has transitioned from an action-oriented, gory Badlands thriller to a more cerebral and emotional arc of the characters. Because I am a fan of the first season, I was also so invested that I eventually papered over the cracks in season 2, which was its inconsistent writing. If you would ask me objectively, I still believe Mirzapur season 2 has enough to keep you hooked and invested for all its 10 episodes. It has several rather odd creative choices that will make you scratch your head wondering, what were they thinking? But dials back to what we originally wanted. Guddu and Golu getting their hands dirty and finally raising the question, who will rule Mirzapur by the end of season 2? To find that out, you can watch it on Amazon Prime Video. And that was the video, guys. Write down in the comments below what you thought about season 2. Please don't forget to follow me on Instagram. The handle's right in front of you. Follow me at JammyPants4. Also, please support us by smashing the like button and subscribing to our channel for weekly content ahead. Thank you for watching.